These are the parallel plates. Whenever it is connected, these two plates are connected to the external charges. Yes, due to the polarization, opposite charges will be developed on the plates. Now, field lines always travels from positive to negative. That means some flux is exchanging from positive charge plate to the negative charge plate of a capacitor. Outer region, there is no field is existed. No field is existed in the outer region. So, E outer is zero. But E inner, what is the surface charge density? Sigma by 2 epsilon naught. Because capacitance is depends upon the total surface area of the conducting plate, which is placed in the conductor. Therefore, E inner is equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught minus of minus sigma by 2 epsilon naught. This is due to the positive charge. This is due to the negative charge. The total is sigma by epsilon naught. Why we applied this sigma by 2 epsilon naught? These two plates occupy some area. Capacitance is depends upon the total surface area of the conducting plates. So, which creates the surface charge density, because the charges are distributed over the surface of the plates. So, E is equal to, or E inner is equal to, means sigma by epsilon naught. What is E? Electric field strength or electric field intensity in the inner region of the capacitor when air is acting as a medium. But we know that sigma is equal to Q by A. Charge per unit area is sigma. So I am substituting sigma is equal to Q by A. Therefore, E is equal to Q by epsilon naught A. But what is potential? Capacitance is directly proportional to the potential, right? So therefore, potential V is equal to, we can write ED, E dot D. Therefore, V is equal to E from equation 1, E is equal to Q by epsilon naught A. Into D. What is capacitance? Q by V. Again, I am bringing this V to the left hand side, right hand side, and this will go to the right hand side. Therefore, Q by V, okay, is equal to this D by epsilon naught A, go to the left hand side and it will become epsilon naught A by D. Q by V is nothing but the capacitance. This is the expression of a parallel plate capacitor with respect to the capacitance when air is acting as a medium between the plates. Capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor is equal to epsilon naught A by D. See, go back to the dependence and independence of the capacitor. Capacitance is dependence upon the area of the conductor, gap between the plates, and epsilon naught. There is no charge or no potential here. That's why we proved that dependence and independence of the capacitance. Now we will see one problem based on the C is equal to epsilon naught A by D formula. Calculate the area of the plates needed to have 1 farad of capacitance for a separation of 1 centimeter. See, the solution of the problem is like this. We should find the area between the plates of a capacitor. But what is the condition? Capacitance is 1 farad and separation is 1 centimeter. Nothing but 10 power minus 2 meters. We are converting into SI system. Now we are finding the A value. What is the rule? C is equal to epsilon naught A by D. Therefore, A is equal to CD by epsilon naught. A is equal to CD by epsilon naught. Now I am substituting the values. C is 1 farad. So A is equal to CD by epsilon naught. C is equal to 1 farad. D is equal to 10 power minus 2 meters. epsilon naught is equal to 8.85 into 10 to the power of minus 12. Therefore, this minus 12 goes up 10 power 10 into 1, 10 power 10 by 8.85. This 8.85 we can take it as approximately 9. So 10 power 10 by 9, it is approximately equal to 10 power 9 meter square, and more than 10 power 9 meter square. That means this should be the area between the plates of the capacitor to produce this much of capacitance when the separation is 1 centimeter. These are the area of the plates of the capacitor, 10 power 9 meter square. Now we are going to see the effect of dielectric on capacitance. Effect of dielectric on capacitance. This means whenever a dielectric medium is placed between the plates of the capacitor, how its capacitance is going to change. This is the thing we are going to discuss here. Whenever a dielectric is placed, the surface charge density will be equal to the original charge density minus polarized charge density, because due to the presence of the dielectric, polarization takes place. We know that. So therefore, E is equal to sigma by epsilon naught in the inner region, as we already know, whenever a dielectric medium is placed, the polarization takes place. Because of the dielectric medium, E will become sigma minus sigma p by epsilon naught. Polarization is always opposite to the applied field, that's why it will be detected. And we are writing sigma minus sigma p as sigma by k. Therefore, E is equal to sigma by k epsilon naught. E is equal to, what is sigma? Q by A. Therefore, Q by AK epsilon naught. V is equal to ED. Therefore, V is equal to Q by AK epsilon naught into D. Q by V is equal to capacitance, and this whole thing will go to the same. That means AK epsilon naught by D is equal to Q by V. Q by V is nothing but the capacitance. Therefore, capacitance is equal to K into A epsilon naught by D. See, we can see some differences in the expressions in the presence of dielectric, in the absence of dielectric. In the presence of dielectric, the capacitance will become K into A epsilon naught by D. What is this K? Dielectric constant. So we can write capacitance or capacity of a capacitor with dielectric medium is equal to the K times the capacitance of capacitor without dielectric. If you see the definition, it is like the capacity of a capacitor with the dielectric medium is equal to the K times the capacity of capacitor without dielectric. See, C is equal to K into A epsilon naught by D. We can write it separately in a bracket. What is this A epsilon naught by D? Capacitance of a capacitor, of a parallel plate capacitor without dielectric medium. So now we are going to discuss about this K. What is this K? What are the definitions?
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.